North Korea began operation of the Yangdeok Spa Resort, newly opened last month in the country's central region on January 10th. Earlier on January 8th, Masikryong Ski Resort, located on its east coast, also began receiving tourists for this season. Both are one of the pet projects of North Korean leader Kim Jong-un to nurture the tourism industry. However, questions still remain over whether North Korea is safe enough for foreigners to tour, as shown in the case of Park Gwangja or Otto Warmbier. This week, North Korea Now will look into the North Yangdeok Spa Resort and Masikryong Ski Resort, which seem as apparent effort to attract more foreign tourists in the face of global sanctions crippling its economy. The official name of Yangdeok Spa Resort is Yangdeok Hot Spring Cultural Recreation Center, located in the north-south Pyongan province. Let's take a look at the related report of Korean Central TV first. The broadcast began with orchestra music and sound effect of bubbling water, presenting aerial drone shots of the hotels, ski grounds, indoor and outdoor spas, and equestrian grounds.
"인민들이 건강하고 문명한 생활을 향유하도록 하기 위해 우리 당은 산 좋고 물 좋고 지형 치세도 좋은 양덕군의 온천 지구를 종합적이고 현대적인 온천 문화 휴양지, 특색 있는 인민 봉사 기지로 전지 개벽시켰습니다."
It then showed the interior of lobbies and hotel rooms, amenities such as vending machines in covered walkways, drinking stands at the indoor pools, and the new ski equipment. It is a city-like resort with an area of 1.66 million square meters. Representing Yangdeok Spa Resort is the hot spring, and above all, the hot spring is said to have outstanding healing effect. Kim had guided its construction through 7 visits between August 2018 and December 2019, highlighting his strong determination to build a competitive tourism industry. Masikryong Ski Resort is also one of the pet projects of the leader, who reportedly enjoyed skiing while attending schools in Switzerland in the early 1990s. The North completed the lavish ski resort on the outskirts of the eastern city of Wonsan in December 2013. The construction of the ski resort came as North Korea has been under a set of sanctions imposed by the UN Security Council for its nuclear and missile tests. According to a North Korean propaganda website, the resort is about 14 million square meters in its total area and has 10 slopes which are 40 meters to 120 meters wide. It added that the average length of the slope is 1,700 meters, with one of them being over 5,000 meters high. At the resort, where high-priced European equipment such as Swedish snowmaking machines and Italian snowplows were sometimes disputed as a violation of sanctions, South and North Korean skiers held joint training sessions ahead of the 2018 Pyeongchang Winter Olympics. As mentioned earlier, it is true that North Korea, a reclusive country, is not yet easy for foreigners to make a comfortable visit. For example, the United States has imposed a ban on its people making trips to the North. After the release of Otto Warmbier, an American college student, he died in 2017, shortly after being sent home from Pyongyang in a coma, following a 17-month detention in North Korea. Back in 2008, a South Korean tourist Park Gwangja was also killed by a North Korean guard at Mount Geumgang Resort on northeast coast. North Korea seems to be making every effort to boost its tourism industry, which is not subject to sanctions, at a time when strong sanctions on the North have blocked the channel of making foreign currency. However, some observers say that it is unclear whether the North will be able to achieve its desired goal due to the aforementioned circumstances. What are your thoughts on this? Please let me know in the comments below, and thank you for watching North Korea Now!